DASS, Disability Awareness Teacher Support Service. Presents Ms. Comfort Walker's visit to Anglo Special School in Tegby. Ms. Comfort Walker believes that special education teachers have the capacity to profoundly impact their local and global communities in immensely positive ways. The extent of that impact, however, will be determined to a large extent by whether these teachers receive the focused assistance they require to meet the unique challenges of their students. On 25th of January 2022, Ms. Comfort Walker visited Anglo Special School in Tegby, in the Volta region of Ghana. As part of her passion to help educate teachers who are also helping children with disabilities, the visit was very inspiring, as the two parties involved who are of similar visions had the opportunity to interact and share their acquired knowledge over the years in their chosen field.
So here's the school, Anglo. Finally. So we are just going to just observe the students a little bit. I'm going to say some few things and interact, okay? So right now, I think they have an activity going on, okay? And there are only 4 students and 2 assistants right now working with our students.
The visit comprised both interactive and educative sessions involving not only the two founders but the management, thus, teachers as well as pupils of the Anglo Special School.
Fine. You can understand me? Good. 17 years old. Okay. Oh, great, you have a schedule. Okay. Complete, of course, every day is not the same. All right.
What do we have?
Okay. Now, so I love that tree. Do you guys utilize under the tree as well?
After.
The sun is like very high. Right. So basically, she's using her porch right now as the school, and she's hoping finally to get a building so that the students will have a place to go to the disability awareness community as well. We'll have a place to, what do you guys call them? The disability council or the disability association. They don't have anywhere to hang out, so she's actually going to have her school open up to that community to do meetings and things like that.
The founder of the center, Ms. Salah, had the opportunity to learn some basic principles and approaches for effective teaching and learning, coached by Ms. Walker, who is also a teacher to students living with disabilities.
So basically, what you can do is you can always find, he has a very good grasp, so it's workable. He has for sure, he's not taken and all that, so it's not what you can do with his hands. That's good.
I was trying to figure out what his eyes were saying.
That was a really good one. That's a good one. I like that. You're using your resources. That's good because sometimes you always have to have the student's name. You know, they may not remember how to spell, but it's fine that you have another bottle, so it's easy reference.
And you use the skills. Good skills.
And you want the letter.
Because you don't want him to lose that skill. Because you don't want him to lose that hand motion in that field.
So what you need to do is make sure that he does exercises that will enhance that. So if you have like a bag of rice, right? It could be fine motor skills. So they have to find all these little stones in the rice, in the all that is making him work on his hands. Right? So they put some things, some small stones in 10 days in here in a round container. Right? And you can find sand and put things inside and let him dig for it. It all helps with his hand. You can kind of use that motor skills. Okay? So this is more visual learning. Now there's three kind of learning. There's visual, auditory, and tactile learning, right? Tactile learning is if you have the letter, let's say he has this, right? If you put these letters in the shape of this over here, or you cut out cards and put the letters yourself, then what he does is when you have the sun, it's good to fill it in, but also it's good for him to form the letters himself. So if you have, one second, sweetheart. So he can now say sun, right? So that's tactile. Picking, also let him find it with the letters. So now you're doing two things, writing, tactile, visual, and he's processing. He has to go through all of these to make this. So you've already told him to find you, spell sun. Now use all these letters in front of you and pick out the letter to spell sun. So that would help him express that as well, right? So that he's not bored with just writing this. He has other things. Or you can say, all these things you have, let's go write it on the sand. Give him to get up, go somewhere, and make that same motion, right? Or you can even say, oh, find stones and spell the word. Or find, cut up leaves and use the leaves to spell the words. Reinforce. Right. So don't always think paper and pen, because you want to change the environment, the things, right? Okay, so even with him, he's learning the alphabet, right? He's learning information. He's Kafi. Hi, Kafi. How are you? You're fine. You're looking for the letters? Okay.
The DATSS team. We're taking on a tour to see some extracurricular activities the students embark on, such as animal farming, which they had in their possession, some rabbits they rear at the backyard of the school. They had also nursed some plants and other plants in the quest to make teaching and learning interesting.
Basically, she was just showing the other plants that she has that the students are involved in, right? This is really good.
After their learning session, the two leaders had the opportunity to share with one another.
So, we are here to meet a really good friend, right? Well, she has become my friend, whether she likes it or not. But I'm going to call her my friend. And basically, I would like her to introduce herself, and then she's going to talk a little bit about who she is. And then I'll ask questions as she talks, and then it becomes a conversation, right?
So please tell us where you are first.
So we are in Keta, Keta in the Volta region.
Okay, yes. Keta in the Volta region.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So you tell us who you are and what you're about.
My name is Emma Sala.
Emma Sala. And so Emma, you work with students with disabilities.
That's right.
Right? So can you tell us why you went into that part of education?
I am now in school, back in school, studying about children.
Okay.
But then working with children with disabilities started for me in 2012.
Okay.
Where I actually applied for, there's this program run by Vodafone Ghana Foundation, Vodafone World of Difference.
Oh.
That gives opportunity to individuals to support or work with any organization, charity organization in their community. So yes, I applied and decided to work with the Autism Center in Kokomimli, Accra. So that project was supposed to be between November, December 2012. But then after it ended, I had developed some attachments to the children. So I continued going there and working with the children. And after that, I actually started an inclusion program where I invited regular children to the center to work in the classroom with the children.
Okay.
Yes. And then we as well went out, like one of the days, to the beach.
Okay.
Yes, because I wanted the children to interact out of the classroom as well. Yes. And we did that at the center in Kokomimli, and we did another one in Bando in the Volta region. Yes. As we documented it, actually, I was hoping to make some videos out of and put it out there, because whilst I started going to the center, I had people tell me I should be careful, I don't end up having such children. Mm-hmm. There were so many negative, yes, so many negative comments.
Mm-hmm.
And some people also think these children can't really do anything. Yes.
Right.
And some people are even afraid of them.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, they're afraid to even get close to them because they think their children are violent or they are evil, you know,
right,
that kind of thing.
Right.
Yes. And for me, I believe inclusion should start from the earlier years. Yes,
right.
So that is why
preschool,
yes,
kindergarten.
Yes,
yes,
yes. So that is the reason why I did that.
Okay.
So I was hoping to do more of that with other schools, but I didn't get the support.
Right.
And so yes, in 2017, I lost my mom.
Aww.
And I have a friend here who works at the nursing school, my childhood friend.
Okay.
And because of her, I used to visit here during some weekends and holidays, and I loved it.
Okay.
So being very close to my mom, like we are two, and I'm the youngest, so like I was really close to her. I was really, really hit by her passing. So I decided to come here and then put myself together.
Right.
Yes. and Ball's hair. That is when the idea to start, because I asked him, I went to the local assembly, asked about the children, and realized there was like really no facility.
Did they receive you when you went to the local?
Yes, they were really nice to me. Okay. So I realized there was no facility here. And the few children that were enrolled in school had to go all the way to Hohe. Hohe is over, I think, 200 kilometers from here.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
Over 4 hours drive. So I was like, okay, why don't we start something as well?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. And they were like, sure, it's possible.
Wow.
Yes.
So did they give you the land? Did they give you the building?
No.
Okay. How am I supporting? What are we supporting?
No. So I needed an accommodation. Yes. I needed accommodation to start. So yes, they scouted for a place for me. Yes. Okay. And I had to seek some support from a few friends to pay for it. And so in 2018 October we started with one boy, and then over the period we've had a few more join us.
Are they paying? The parents are paying you to go to school?
No, we don't take a dime, because the parents cannot afford to pay.
And that's another barrier, is the finance.
Because even those going to school in Hohe, most of them are not able to go consistently, because government pays for part of the fees, and the parents are supposed to provide provisions. But even that, some parents are not able to. So if school resumes and they are not able to get that, the children stay home.
Right. So, and then if they have a choice between a regular child and a child with a disability, they rather will support the regular child,
and
our students will be left at home.
Yeah.
So it's definitely a good thing that it is free. Now, the other question is, if that's free, how are you supporting yourself?
Okay, so I knew I had to figure out something to keep us running.
Yes.
So I started a seafood business.
Okay.
Yes. So I source seafood from the local women, package, and then send to Accra. Yes. So I started that a month earlier before the school started. So that started like September 2018, and the school took off a month later.
Yes. Do the students help you with this packaging? Is that part of a vocational program, or this is just you on the side doing it?
It's just me on the side.
Okay, now we're talking to an angel right here. So I've been loving you even more. I am just loving you even more. So right now, your total amount of students that you have now is
six.
Yeah. And your assistants that support you in this moment is
two.
Yes. So we got three of you and six students, right? So in this one space building at the moment,
I'm definitely
going to see it.
Working from my porch.
You're working from your porch.
Yes.
Okay. You are a keeper. You are the she is the first of every thing that I ever wanted to do in special education in Africa, in developing country. You will forever be DATSS first baby. You are not going anywhere, okay? Every other organization that steps up will just have to wait till you get met. That's how my heart feels. And I'm so happy that I got a chance to meet you, that you are here to talk to me. So before we end this and then we do our own private conversation, I want you to share with us, what do you feel you need right now that will even give you more ease in your quest in supporting our students with disability in your community, right? What is your dying support? Because that takes stories and make it our project.
Okay.
That's what we do. We don't bring projects. We take what we hear and make it our project. That's one of the areas of DATSS. So tell the DATSS family out there what can we do for you?
So our major challenge is accommodation. Yes, because we work from the porch. When the sun gets very high, sometimes yes, it comes to where we are working, and then when it rains too, yes, it worries us a lot. So our major challenge is accommodation, because we also have people interested in coming around to volunteer and all that, but because
local
we don't
people
have,
or international
yes, local people.
Okay,
and so because we don't have accommodation, we cannot host them.
So when you say accommodation, you're talking about buying the land, start the building project, or you're talking about finding a building to rent to have this accommodation? Like, what are you looking at?
Okay, we've applied for a land from the local assembly.
Okay.
We are almost about finishing the process. So if that happens, yes, we want to put up a structure, and most especially a playground, because even in the community there's no playground for the regular children. So yes, we want to be able to do something like that, so the regular children can also come in from time to time.
That's where the inclusion part comes in. If it's just the play part, it's still an inclusion, right? It doesn't always have to be in the classroom. So that's definitely a good way to bring the community in to you and have our students actually express themselves out
and
there.
And aside that, even the disability association here, they don't really have a place that they hold their meetings and all that. So yes, if we're able to put something like that together,
that would also invite
would
them.
Open up, yes, would open up to them.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
That is amazing dream. And it's definitely something that will, it's possible. It's possible.
Yes.
So, definitely DATSS is going to look into your project. Definitely going to look into it. We're going to, again, see how we can support, right? But one of the DATSS major support, this is the most important support that we believe in, is supporting the teachers. Going back to school is expensive, right?
Very.
So if we are waiting for our teachers or those who have a heart to teach our student to go to college, because you can't even have special education degree until you do a master's level? Well, you got a special education.
Yeah, master's.
So now you have a whole bachelor's. All you have is just introduction to education.
Yeah.
But to be a special ed teacher here, you need a master's. That's a lot of money spent and a lot of time that a lot of us don't have. So what DATSS is saying is, we will give you the courses. We will give you the skills and the resources so that your teachers don't have to struggle. You don't have to think, how am I going to learn this? How am I going to do that? So that's a wrap. And I'll let you know later everything that we are going to look into. We're going to look into their project. We're going to list it down. We're going to try and come with a budget, what it's going to cost to make it happen. And you, that community, are going to come in the care station, in the care box station, and support this dream. And supporting this dream supports DATSS, right? Because that's dream. DATSS wants to support. And through that, their dreams can come true as well. Our students can be safe, and being in an environment is amazing. So thanks for watching. I'll talk to you guys later.
This piece is a word of motivation to both teachers and students living with disabilities, to adjust to all circumstances that comes up in the discharge of their duties, and for students to also put in their all to change their inabilities into abilities. This will result in changing the narrative about persons living with disabilities. For further information or to support us, please contact us, Irvington, New Jersey, 07111, United States of America, or visit info@dats.org. DATSS, supporting teachers of students with disabilities.